Magari, Coneri. I don't know what to say. I saw you, Domitri. Alvaro Mori. Na 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 na. Ba 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 ba. So my video for today would be about tips for newly launched talent teachers here at Native Camp. If you're watching this video, you might be waiting for your talent badge to be placed on your profile. So congratulations in advance for becoming a newly launched talent teacher here at Native Camp. Teaching with the talent method might be a little bit challenging because it is very different from the regular textbooks that you usually teach, right? But don't worry though, because I will give you 10 tips on how to survive on your first week teaching with the Kellen Method with your Kellen Method half price badge. Oh! Just a disclaimer, you guys, these tips are based on my experience. Okay, so yes, let's move on. Tip number one. Do not teach consecutively, save your voice. When I was a newly launched Kellen teacher, I was very, very overwhelmed because Kellen lessons are book lessons. I opened a lot of slots. So after 2 days, I lost my voice. And I was absent for 2 to 3 days in the office. Let's try to avoid that, okay? For you to avoid these instances, you can work for 2 hours, take a 30-minute break, work for 2 hours, take another 30-minute break. During this break time, you can practice the head words. You can practice or read in advance the new word. You can practice the revision, and you can prepare yourself. Because for me, Kellen Half Price is the real training. Always drink a lot of water every after class, because you are still adjusting with the method. It would be better if you would always have water beside you. Kukunan natin ang ating bosses sa Kellen Half Price or sa Kellen method. So please save your voice. Tip number two, relax. At least try. If you panic, then there is more likely that the student will also panic. If you stutter, more likely the student will also stutter. Just relax, or at least try to relax. Okay, because if you don't relax, then you might misread the words, you might mispronounce the words, what happened to me. And also, if you panic, more likely the student might think that this teacher is not ready for the lesson, and they might give you a low rating, and I think you know what will happen next. Tip number three, always follow the Kellen rule. When Kellen students take our class, either they are using PC or they are using their smartphone, the only thing that they can see in their side is the Kellen rule. If the student can see that you're not following the Kellen rules, then they might think that you weren't trained well. Please always follow the Kellen rules. You can see it in the Kellen for nutshell. You can see it in the level check test. Okay, so I just want to highlight something, especially for following the student's request. Please do avoid that. And Kellen, us teachers are the boss in the lesson. Students cannot make a request. Students cannot tell you to speak slower. Students cannot tell you to speak faster. So whatever their students request in the student's account, please disregard it. Okay? Yes. Tip number four. Always double, triple check your students' progress. Because there might be sometimes that instead of FSR, it's new work. Instead of new work, it's QSR. So you need to double check. Because I tried it before that the previous teacher placed full stage revision instead of new work. So when I had a full stage revision, the student complained and gave me a low rating. So try to always check. Always not double, triple check the student's progress, because they might complain and give you a low rating. Tip number five, label your Kellen charts. Familiarize your Kellen chart. I think you were already given the PDF before your Kellen training. Please do label it. Try to familiarize with the charts, because it would take a long time, especially if you're teaching stage 1, stage 2, and stage 3. Most of the questions would need some charts. So you need to familiarize your charts very well. There are 2 charts that are commonly used, the classroom and the Bram family. I advise you to put it in your right side, and then the rest of the charts, put it in your left side. so that you know where to get. Okay? Yes. Tip number 6, always check if your Google Chrome is up to date or your laptop or PC's system software is updated. Because I've tried it before that while I was having a Calm class, my laptop suddenly restarted. In my case, before I leave my workplace, I usually check my Google Chrome and I also check my laptop software if it is up to date. Tip number 7, know the basic troubleshooting. So in Kalan Method lesson, again, all classes are reserved. Time is gold in Kalan, do not waste your time. In my case, if the student's connection is not good, I advise them to turn off their camera. My camera would be the only one that will be seen in the platform because of the charts. If there's a problem with your internet connection, tell your student to refresh, to reconnect, or if the student can't hear you, tell them to reconnect, and also the teacher should reconnect. Or in worst cases, I've tried that these days I have experienced that my students cannot hear me. I told my student to please go to their settings and then allow the native cam application to access the microphone, and then I told them to refresh and then it was all good. Try to familiarize yourself with the basic troubleshooting, because for me it's really a waste of time if you keep on refreshing and refreshing and then no lesson has been done. So as much as possible, we need to have the revision and new work and the reading in one lesson. Tip number 8. Never show your hands in the camera. Okay? When I was still a new launch Kalan teacher, I do this a lot. For me, doing this one, it's like for us teachers to get the momentum, you know, the timing of a student. So as much as possible, you need to put your hands down, because I have experienced before that I had a student, I was doing like this in the camera and then my student's face was also like this. Okay? So let's try to avoid that as much as possible. We want the student to focus on our face, on our mouth, so that they can enunciate and pronounce the words well. Tip number 9, always send the student's progress immediately after your class. Because I have experienced, especially in Kalan Half Price, the students would book 4 classes consecutively, 3 classes or 2 classes consecutively. We don't want the next teacher to have troubles, right? Send the progress immediately so that the next teacher wouldn't have any complaints. Because if this teacher will be complained, then the previous teacher will be the one to be blamed. We don't want that to happen, right? Tip number 10, enjoy. First, it'll be very difficult. Yes, I know that very well. But as time goes by, it'll be very, very easy. Trust me, you guys. I have talked to some talent teachers who are not half price anymore, or they don't have the talent half price patch anymore. They told me, Taffy, thank you so much for the advices you gave me. Now I'm very familiar with the method. I'm really happy that you really pushed me to accept the invite and so on and so forth. Just enjoy. Whatever mistakes you did in your previous talent class, try to avoid making that mistake again in your succeeding classes, because for me the real training is in Kalan Half Price. Try to enjoy, learn from your mistakes, and avoid doing it again in your succeeding lessons. The purpose of having the Kalan Method Half Price tag is for you to get used to teaching with the method. In my own honest opinion, the real training or the real demo is in Kalan Half Price tag. You would meet a lot of students with different skills. So that is the challenge in there. There would be a student that is slow, there would be a student that is fast, there would be a student that has an American accent. You need to deal with the skills or the English skills of your student. Receiving low ratings in your Kalan Half Price days for me is normal. Again, it's normal. Do not panic. Again, learn from your mistakes. You are still adjusting, you are still learning with the method. Do not panic, it's normal. In my own honest opinion, you can see how you did well every after class if you've improved or not based on the ratings of your students. So every after class, try to check your ratings if it became higher or it became lower. If it became lower, then try to improve yourself. Try to think that, what did I do to deserve this rating? Try to critique yourself that, what should I improve? Should I improve on pronunciation? Should I improve on my prompting? Should I improve on my teaching skills? Your adjusting is totally okay. Because for me, ratings can be improved. It refreshes every Sunday. I also experienced that, so it's okay. We're all in this together. If you still haven't subscribed to my channel, please do so. And if you do like this video, please give this video a big thumbs up. And please do not forget to turn on the post notifications so that you get notified whenever
I like. 죽는다, whenever she posts another video.
Again, it's Sheppy, and I will see you guys soon. Bye!